Joseph Farmoir!
That's Joseph Farmoir! He's trying to take my sister away from me!
Joseph Farmoir! For the brief moment that she stood with him in the living room, she felt justified he separated from her.
But it's fair to see I stood at the threshold of an unknown
room. Waiting for the sun to reveal its breathtakingly beautiful scenery. But that feeling, that feeling only lasted for a moment. Katya could not allow them to have an affair.
Sayo
cried bitterly.
And why was this a gateway?
She cried until there were no more tears to weep.
How could I come across the man I told so fittingly for the body in my heart? It was a mistake to the Katya Mantri.
She was angry with everybody in Asila, especially with Uncle Simiren, for ruining her relationship with Joseph Farmoir.
Even before it started,
The mere mention of Joseph Farmoir's name delighted a feeling in her heart.
Is Joseph so that you're of the same clan? And therefore forbidden to have an heterosexual lead.
This unfair outdated culture was a searing torment to her and other progressive minds. Radiant situation grew worse.
My world is spinning around.
Our world was spinning around.
The threat of circumcision is becoming
real. The threat of circumcision was becoming real.
All of them stand
up. That old man.
That old man said that you must undergo the cultural night.
Radiant did not find it funny. When she thought of that young man who grinned impudently at them, he kept on reminding them that they were in Choye, Nemegalana.
God forbid!
Yes, God forbid!
Don't be that law that comes will only touch me over my death!
But our only escape route will be through her sister, yet she had failed her.
Taya Eyeyo, I trusted you to persuade my mind to allow us to go back to Nakuru and enroll at the Egerton University, but you're not even trying.
An appropriation of Rosa made itself.
No, Taya, you're not even trying. Taya!
Taya! Taya! Taya! She will press her sister even more. Dawn came. It was morning also in the master bedroom.